people come up to me and be like, you're in Star Wars, right? I see your Facebook posts. There's nothing else to your personality. And because I figured out the magic of this black box here, I'm gonna add some fun stuff in here. Hello?
Obi-Wan never told you what happened to your father. He told me enough! He told me you killed him. No, I am your father.
So cool. So anyways, let's get on to the actual set. I'm really bad with time, so I have a little timer set up, so I would go over, and I'm gonna set that right here. Cool. And so the world is a very complicated place. And so I like to do a lot of things where I'll use like symbols or metaphors or some way to simplify things so I can understand it better. For example, doggy style and reverse cowgirl are the same position, just on different axes. I'm also a very big fan of Animal Farm, you know. Snowball, or should I say Leon Trotsky? With international conflicts, I always like to have this like scenario in my head where each country is a kid and they're all on a playground, and like the entirety of the history of the world is all just a bunch of kids playing on a playground. So you have America, who's like the, you know, like the kind of shitty white kid who's just always has this like chest puffed out, and he's always carrying like a huge super soaker at his side, and he's always just like, "Sup, dude? How are you, man?" And he always pisses off all the other countries. Like, he never bothers to learn the names of any of the African kids. So he just assumes they're all the same country. Like, "Hey, Africa, come over here." And he's like, "My name is Zambia, you fuck." Yeah, okay, Africa. Other Africa, you too. "My name's South Africa." Don't stop fucking with me. There's only one Africa. The only name he bothers to learn is Egypt, because he keeps trying to dress up as her for Halloween, and it makes her super uncomfortable. Whenever he talks to India, he keeps trying to do the accent, and India's just like, "You're an asshole." And you have other countries like Canada, who's nicest guy in the world, not a mean bone in his body. He's gonna live like the picture-perfect life. He's gonna wind up marrying someone like beautiful and cultured, like Iceland or France. You have China, who wasn't that intimidating when he was younger, but like he hit puberty and then it was like, ooh. Started to steal some of the thunder out from underneath America. And China, of course, always lived next door to the Korea twins. And South Korea, really cool guy, very, very hip, very trendy, has very distinct style about him. He likes to sing, likes to dance. He's the shittiest fucking brother. Oh my god, this kid told everybody he was gonna fire off a Roman candle in the hallways, but he's a pathological liar. You had another set of twins, Australia and New Zealand. Australia was the kid who, anywhere you go, he'd find a snake and show it to you. Like, "Crikey, look at this bang!" And his sister, New Zealand, was, you know, very nice, very, very, very pretty, but I swear to god, when England introduced you to the Lord of the Rings books, it's all she talked about. For like a year. And of course, England and Ireland are cousins, and they don't get along very well, because Ireland's a bit more of a rough and tough kind of kid, and England always wanted to hang with the posh guys, like Switzerland and Luxembourg, who aren't even in the playground, they're inside, like, studying economics textbooks. And the kids would come to school in like Giorgio Armani hoodies, and they're like 10 years old, like, come on. But Ireland was the kid who was always somehow able to swipe a beer from his dad's fridge, and he'd walk up to you like, "Hi there, you lads want to try maybe to control the crate check?" And you're like, "I have no one's idea, I know what the fuck you're talking about." And so these kids get into all these like crazy shenanigans. For example, oh my god, one time, Russia got a really, really cool super soaker, like one that could like rival America's, and so America got really worried about it, and so they both just started pointing them at one another. Walk around like this, they're like, you get me wet? You get me wet, I'll get you wet, so you better not get me wet, because then everybody's gonna be wet. America turns around and Cuba has another super soaker on the side, and he's like, shit! But it's okay, because Turkey's also pointing one at Russia. Even before that, though, oh my god, one time for show and tell, Austria brought in his gerbil, Franz Ferdinand. Some fucking kid, thought it'd be a good idea to feed the damn thing paste. Everyone's going insane, they're all in the playground, they're digging trenches all over the place. They grab mustard packets from the cafeteria and start chucking it at each other. That was a joke about mustard, yes. You think, like, once that got settled, everything would be fine, but then, just the next day, they're playing kickball, and, you know, they look up, and suddenly Germany is the only one in the outfield, and they're like, Germany, what happened to Poland? And he's like, oh, dear. Oh, my God, I do believe that Poland sprained his ankle. This is very curious indeed. And he's like wringing his hands maniacally, like muttering to himself. And everyone's like, okay, we'll deal with that later. Few innings go by, suddenly it's just Germany, Italy, and Japan just like beating all the European kids. And meanwhile, America's in the dugout playing Pokemon, like, this is not my problem. But Japan decides he gets a little too power hungry, he's on a bit too many pixie sticks. He kicks the kickball right at America, hits him in the head, and America's like, okay! Now I'm going down!